Okay, so let's go ahead with the pork belly. It's in the fridge. I asked my butcher to boneless and to have it boneless and skinless. And the most important really is to have a pork belly with quite a lot of fat on top. It will help to preserve it, you know, much better. But my butcher's been a little fucker. It's not very much fat. But let's show you anywhere how to proceed. So first of all, I get a gastro or a gratin dish, anything you can have quite deep to place your piece of meat in there with the salt. So would you excuse me, it's a big bag of salt. Okay, I put first layers of salt into my gastro, yeah? The first layer. So here, now, on this salt, a nice flat layer, we're just gonna put a few spice as you want. So I decide to put, first of all, I like the garlic taste for a pork belly. So we're gonna crush garlic like that with your hand. Yeah, it's all crushed. And then you hiding it in your salt underneath. Don't make contact with the meat, otherwise it will be very too strong garlic. This one just give a very nice flavor, very gentle. Then we've put a bit of fresh thyme. Voilà. As Forty said, it looks like a beach. a sand beach. Bit of peppercorn. A bit of bay leaves. You can use anything you want, really. Orange peel if you want to do some duck, duck breast. So then, your pork belly, just before to stick it in your salt, you're gonna have to do a kind of a massage with salt. Just to help the salt to penetrate into the meat. So everywhere, it's got to be everywhere. And you do a kind of massage. Shame the pig is dead, he might enjoy that. More salt. And do a massage in every little corners you can find. And this system is exactly the same with a pig leg to do a ham. So you got your pig leg, boneless with a bone, and you have to massage with salt very well. There you go, nada. Then when that's done, you just stick it in your gastro on top of it. So meat at the bottom, fat above. And very well pressed down. And then you just cover it with salt again. There you go. So for this thickness, we're gonna leave it for 5 days into the salt. But now that's done. And then you need some weight on top, very well pressed. It helps the salt to go into the meat. And it helps to remove all the rest of blood, juice, whatever from the meat. So you leave it in the fridge with well pressed down, with some weight on top. Leave it in the fridge. So this is the one we made 5 days ago. It's been pressed, see, in the fridge. And see how the salt, it went damp. You see? That's because of the meat. All the water, the juice from the meat just went out. And see, it's pretty dry now. And you got your spice, we've just put. I already smell. Mona.
It is already a good smell.
And see, the meat is already dry from the salt, it's nearly cooked already, basically. Oh, this is very, very good. And so at this stage, you give a very good wash under cold water. Very, very good wash. Then you dry it. And then you can or smoke it, roll it as a pancetta, voilà, very tight well, and let it hang for probably 4 to 5 months. So let's clean it.
Wipe it up.
That's okay. Yeah. So this is a clean piece of meat just came out from the salt. See, it went thinner. It went dry. It's fantastic. Beautiful. So then you dry it very well, in every little corner again. Don't leave a drop of moist, because that could damage it. But you got to clean it very well because it is very salty. Yeah. Would you get some string? Huh?
Yes.
Okay, that's pretty well dry. So at this stage, I really like it very peppery. So I'm gonna add some pepper on top. Then we're gonna roll it as tight as possible. It's a very tiny one, huh? But you can make the whole length of the pork belly. It's what we do usually, one.
Yes, it is. Much bigger ones.
Yeah. Voilà. Okay. And then we're just gonna tight it with the string. Do you have a scissors, my pool? I need to remember that. No. Attends. All right. Thanks. That's okay. Yeah. So you need to very tight it very well. If you can't do it, just go back to your butcher. I'm sure he will do it for you. Then I go this way. To do one here, no? Shall we? Then you pass a little, do little knot, just to finalize it. Go. Do a knot here. Scissors. Ready to hang. Well tight. And then he's gonna go for proving. That means he's got to stay outside at 20 degrees in a room temperature. That will help the meat to relax after being stabbed with the salt, and then it will help the first dry. So after 24 hours at 20 degrees roughly, we stick it in a cold room. 12 degrees to 15 max, with quite a lot of humidity, 80% of humidity. Same for every cured meat, really. Ham, pancetta, saucisson, every cured meat will be the same kind of temperature and process of drying.
So, only in the time of drying.
Yeah.